Bishop, 10 years he's done this, made his own way, made the unofficial UCSB mascot. He's actually a high school basketball coach and a teacher, and he usually runs around and annoys people, and he came by earlier and bothered us as well, so we got him back just a little bit. I think he was looking for a date for the dance, Tammy, because he was ignoring me, he was all over you.
All right, you did a nice job of protecting me there, stepping up.
Look at him. ride with the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never fly or the enemy, but I'm in the Gaucho Army. Yes, sir! I'm in the Gaucho Army! Yes, sir!
De La Habana, Cuba, mi música. The Gauchos opened the 2002 season with high expectations, but had to begin the year without star Brendan Fuller, who was sidelined with a strained knee. Nevertheless, the Gauchos came out in their first game strong and took a 45-43 lead into the half. In the second period, however, the Gauchos went cold and in a 10-minute span were outscored 26-11. UCSB came back to pull within 3 points, but were never able to regain the lead. UCSB fans were treated to their first look at freshman guard Cecil Brown, whose highly anticipated debut did not disappoint the Thunderdome crowd. Unfortunately, the effort ended in a loss as the Gauchos dropped their first contest of the year.
Too long. Since last time, Vukovic missed the dunk at the buzzer. That's how long I've been waiting for this game.
What do you think the crowd's going to do tonight?
It's going to be awesome. I think it's new breed of Gauchos. I think it's going to just let people know that we're for real. You know, this team proved to us in the NCAA that they're real. They can play big games. And we're just going to let the Big West know we're the team to beat.
Make it 8-3 rather. The Trojans are up by 5. Layup is good by Nick Jones at the other end as they break the full court press in.
After traveling to Alaska for the Top of the World Classic, where the Gauchos struggled in their three games, UCSB returned to the friendly confines of the Thunderdome and blew out the Dons of San Francisco in a warm-up for their biggest game of the young season, a hosting of the Trojans of Southern California. The Gauchos had never beaten USC and had not defeated a Pac-10 opponent since 1989. The game went back and forth during the first half, and going into the break, the Gauchos trailed by just 2 points.
Great job by Brandon Fuller to take the ball right at the big center, shoot right over him. Inside, nothing there. Needs help. 5 seconds inside to Hull, who lays it in. What a cut by Mark Hull. Puts it in for a 7 point. 2 seconds. One. A long shot by Farmer at the buzzer. Two.
When Mark Hull hit a three-pointer to put the Gauchos up 36-35 in the second half, UCSB never trailed after that point. The Gauchos proceeded to go on a 15-5 run, capped by a Cecil Brown three-pointer with 8:36 left in the game, taking a 54-43 advantage. UCSB never looked back as it headed for its third straight win.
Cecil Brown back to Cecil for the layup. Nice job by the Gauchos. Pass up there. They'll reset the offense. Full up, driving in the lane. Scoop to the hoop, puts it up, and he got it! Count it! And it'll go to the line for a three-point opportunity! Great job by Brandon Fuller. Hesitating, takes it to the middle, slides in the middle, gains control of his body after he's bumped, and he puts the ball in the basket. Gauchos by 8 with 8:40 to go. Gauchos break the full court press. 3-on-2. Hall, right side Brown. Layup off the glass. Turn it! And it's good line! Cecil Brown playing the game of his life! He has steals, he has rebounds, and he now has his first points in the game. Now has 4 for the night. Great concentration. Matako avoids the double team. At the top, Hall swings it right. Full of open 3. Good! Great job by Jacoby Matako breaking the press. ESB. The Trojans can't get anything to fall. Farmer just missed a wide open layup there, and it was as far in the basket as it can go without going in. Trojans with only 19 points in the second half. A minute 10 to go. The Gauchos with a 14-point lead. Full up at the right angle to Nick Jones. The crowd on his feet. Shot clock at 15. Here's Jones at the right sideline. To Cook at the top of Taco. Shot clock at 9 at Taco. Penetrates, finds Fuller at the top for 3. He got it! Gauchos, it's a big hit from Jacoby Taco to Brandon Fuller. Gauchos by 17. Dancing around, finds Jones at the top, drives in the lane, all the way to the cup, plays it up and in! Nice job. Second to go. This baby is history. The Gauchos have defeated the USC Trojans.
UCSB out-rebounded the Trojans 41-33, and UCSB's big three of Fuller, Hull, and Jones combined for 55 of the Gauchos' 69 points. Coach Williams called the victory a signature win for the program. UCSB hoped it could carry the momentum into a tough road swing, but it was not to be.
You're good, though. You're good. Hey, you know what? Who played out of their head? Not us. We didn't play. We didn't play. Hey, moral of the story, you want to be an athlete, go to NC. Congratulations to the seniors. Okay? Yeah. Hey, this is a springboard for us. Don't forget it. Let's go. Great goddamn toughness, guys. I'm really proud of you. One, two, three.
Gauchos!
Way to go,
brother.
20 minutes, baby.
The Gauchos were glad to be back at home after spending so much time on the road. UCSB suffered losses at Pepperdine, Cal, BYU, and two defeats at the Arizona State Tournament, and a tough loss at Utah State and at home to Cal State Fullerton. UCSB did have big wins over Idaho on the road and Cal State Northridge during that span. Then the Pacific Tigers, the early Big West surprise team, came home. UCSB's defense was the star of this game, pulling the Tigers' top four scorers to a combined 20 points. The Gauchos also surprisingly out-rebounded Pacific by 6. Brendan Fullev led UCSB with 17 points, while Nick Jones added 14 and Casey Cook chipped in 10. UCSB improved to 4-2 in Big West play. Pauly came into the Thunderdome looking to stop a streak of 9 straight losses to UCSB over the last 3 seasons, including the Big West first-round loss that ended Cal Poly's season last year. Tonight would not be the night for the Mustangs. Mark became UCSB's 4th all-time scorer after tallying 18 points and 11 rebounds. The Gauchos struggled for the victory, however. When Hull hit a 3-pointer with 7:39 left in the first half, that was the last basket UCSB would score until the 15-minute mark in the second half. A span of almost 12 minutes. Cal Poly was able to cut an 11-point Gaucho lead down to 2, but then the Gauchos went on a 12-0 run of their own to go up 44-30. Cal Poly shot only 36% from the field and had 15 turnovers. The win was the Gauchos' 3rd in a row, putting them a half game behind Utah State and tied with UC Irvine for 2nd place in the Big West race.
Driving down the lane, he drives and he puts it in! And a coming offensive foul on Mark Hull!
That's right under the rim. It's directly under the rim.
The defender was right underneath the rim and the call charging on Mark Hull. If anything, that should have a screen at the top. Jackson for 3. Misses short, rebound, spot 4. Barney Dennis has got it, puts it up strong and he puts it in!
He's Brandon Fullev, steps inside, looks right, passes right to Jones, 17-footer, strong.
Jones got the rebound, and it's tipped away, though, into the hands of Brandon Fullev. Fullev pass inside, Jones, who lays it in!
Pretty pass.
Down the lane, all the way to the cup, he lays it up strong, count it, and we'll go to the line for a three-point play. A taco for the first point of the night. Get pass to the left side, Jones for 3, good!
Nick Jones starting to light it up a little bit offensively.
Geary back to Allen at the top, looks inside, ball knocked away, and a deflection by Whitehead, steal by Fula. Here come the Gauchos in transition, Fula down low, lays it in!
That was a pass by Fula for
to Oliver, up to floor Ward, buzzer sounds, and this game is over. Gauchos win it. 70-61, the Gauchos have won three straight. They're now 8-9 overall, 5-2 in the league.
UCSB traveled down the road to Irvine to take on the Anteaters for a Fox Sports televised game at the Bren Center. UCSB could move into a tie for first place with the win, and the Gauchos were ready for the challenge. After UCI hit a three-pointer to open the game, the Gauchos went on a 13-3 run to take a 13-6 lead early on.
In favor of Irvine on the basket by Glozer. Here's Paul, left angle, a three on the way, and he ties the ball game. And he's just one three away from tying the Gauchos' three-point record all time. 17 to shoot, Otako down the lane, he spins, he fakes, leans inside, shoots off the glass, and it's good! Otako on the board, and the Gauchos have a one-point lead.
Very nice.
Hands with a couple of baskets here tonight, Zuzak in the lane, a steal by Nick Jones, it's a two-on-one break. Jones to Davis, down the lane, right-hand layup, good! Off the window, Davis in transition, his first point, so the Gauchos lead by...
Irvine had a small run of their own, outscoring the Gauchos 10-2. But UCSB pulled away from the Anteaters late in the first half by means of a 23-8 run.
The 15 to shoot, Schrader at the top for three. He got it. All right, Irvine goes to full love down the left baseline. Stops, looks for help. And nearing a five count now, a fadeaway shot with the right hand. It's good. Oh, he was in traffic. Player of the game for Irvine finds Hood. Right side three. Count it. And one. He'll come to the line for a potential four-point play. Pat Douglas puts it over and back call. He's not going to get it. Shot clock at eight. Davis down the left baseline. Stopped on a double team. Looks for help. Five to shoot. Cecil Brown, a long three from the left side. Good! From outside, Cecil Brown on the board. He rings the bell. Herb Brown as they run that motion offense. Shot clock is down at 12. Otako at the top, shaking and baking down the lane all the way to the glass. He puts it up and he puts it in. Another tough shot put in by Otako. For Cook, but he's not open. Otako takes it inside, scoops it the hoop, he lays it in! Off the glass, Otako playing out of his mind!
Are you kidding me? Who gave that kid a boost of confidence? He is going offensively against this Irvine front line or back court.
Top, dancing around down the lane, ball knocked away, taken away by Josh Davis, behind the back dribble, all alone, coast to coast, and he lays it in, and he actually threw it down barely with the right hand, a baby dunk for Davis.
When the second half started, the Gauchos were determined not to let Irvine back into the game. UCI was never able to get within 12 points as the Gauchos' defense took charge. UCSB held its opponents to 37% shooting for the game, while the Gauchos made just about one basket for every two attempts. UCSB held the Anteaters' top four scorers to a combined 18 points, while Brendan Fullov led the way with 22 points, while Nick Jones scored 13 and had a career-high seven steals.
Defense by Irvine, motion perimeter game by UCSB. Hull picks a three at the top, and he puts it in, and he ties the school record at 196. Career.
Jones looking for help, finds the cutting full down the lane, scoops to the hoop, he lays it in. Well, Irvine is trapping right now, trying to pick up the pace.
For help, he finds a taco at the top, dribble drive down the lane, spins the pass to the left corner, full up, driving baseline, hanging, shooting, and he put it up, and he put it in. He got hammered, no call, but he drops it in for two.
Duke Brown working one-on-one against the Hebrew, shaking and baking, spinning at the foul line. He looks, the fadeaway shot, right hand, good!
Oh, what a shot by Cecil Brown! And the Gauchos played their best ball to the this part of the season so far. They win tonight on the road at Irvine. A big, big win, 70-54. Top of the circle, one bounce left side of Ross.
The biggest game of the year, for more than one reason, came rolling into the Thunderdome as the Gauchos hosted first place Utah State. The Gauchos had just suffered a demoralizing one-point loss to Long Beach State. Brendan Fullov had one of the worst games of his career in Logan only a few weeks earlier, and the Gauchos wanted to share first place again. Fullov made only 3 of 12 shots at Utah State in a 16-point defeat, but in the rematch scored a game-high 21 on 9 of 13 shooting. Utah State big man Desmond Penninger scored his first and only 2 points with 3:46 left in the first half as the Gaucho defense stifled the Aggie threats. Phillip became just the 20th player in Gaucho history to rack up 1,000 career points as he scored 15 of his game-high 21 in the second half.
Signed to Oliver, he spins inside to the top, Davis a three on the way, and it's good! Right baseline all the way to the cup, he missed it, an air ball was there for the rebound, and the putback is Whitehead. Cecil Brown shows quickness as he went around. Now in the foul line, he stops, shoots a 15-footer, and he hit it! Good move. He shook his defensive man off of him. Good corner Davis inside a cutting Cook. Turn around shot right hand. Running around and it goes in. Otako finding Jones right baseline. Strong move to the hole. And he puts it in. It's Jones to the board for the first time tonight. On four. Otako down the lane. Scoop to the hoop. He missed the shot. It came so close to going in. He's fouled. He'll go to the line for two. Drive left baseline, stop on the double team, left corner, hole for three. Over the Gaucho. Otako down the lane, finds full love, right baseline, hanging, shooting, and he scores! Third push catch right to full love, he fakes the three in the right corner hole. He's got two threes made on the night, he steps inside at the foul line. At the top is Jones, fade away, long 3-point shot, and it goes.
UCSB built a 45-32 lead before a six-minute drought allowed Utah State to climb back into the game and within 3 points at 45-42. Then UCSB caught fire as Phillips scored 12 points in the last 8 minutes of the game to help the Gauchos pull away. UCSB improved to 7-3 in the league and moved back into first place.
Layup is good by Nelson. Bob Williams wants a timeout. Full love at the top at three on the way. High-arcing shot and it goes in. Play, running the motion offense, using some of that clock. Here's full love at the top. A three on the way. He got it!
That's the guy who got to be hanging on to Brandon Fuller's jersey.
Here's full love one-on-one against Butler. Dribble drive. Now a pull-up high arcing three. Good! One, this baby's over. UCSB gets revenge, get redemption on Utah State. The Gauchos beat Utah State 62-50. The Gauchos and Aggies are tied for first place to the Big West with a record of 7-3.
Hey, feel it. Feel it. It's got to be right in here. You got to be ready to show up there Saturday, and you got to be ready to play. Whitehead,
good shit.
Where the hell you been? That was great. You went out, and you weren't going to be denied. And at the defensive end, you went after, and you were a beast. Yeah. All right? All right, and full of that was sick. Unbelievable performances. That was amazing. Some of those shots last one, I go, go to the hole, go to the hole! Boom, rainbow. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Good shot. Whoa. Great Gaucho effort, one of the best. One, two, three.
Gauchos!
On the dribble, driving right baseline. He stops, he pops, he shoots, count it, and they'll go to the line for more. Jacoby Atata shows them. Swings it up to Fula, who fakes the three. At the top, Cecil Brown for three. Good!
Trying to keep some of the intensity and fire from two nights before proved a tough task for the Gauchos as they hosted Idaho. After struggling with their shot for most of the game, UCSB came from behind to win and stay in first place. Brendan Fuller led the Gauchos with 13 points. The Gauchos could hit only 33% of their shots for the night and at one point missed 9 straight shots, allowing the Vandals to take a 5-point lead. But UCSB took over the lead on the strength of a 15-0 run to end the game and keep their Big West title hopes alive.
This is Jones, angle dribble right. He finds Hull for three. He got it! There it is! His first field goal of the game. Down the lane, 10 to shoot. Otako leans inside the full left layup. Good! And a foul! Has good of the line! Perfectly
three-point play.
Kobe Atafo worked really hard to get that pass inside to Brandon Pollock. Brandon held his ground. Whitehead comes out. Here's Tennant at the top. Puts up a three. Short. Rebound ripped away by Atafo. He climbs. Pat Williams up a screen. Left-handed three. Missing short. Rebound on the floor. Fought for. Picked up by Atafo. Puts the defense in the backcourt. He got hammered. No call. Lee passes down. Wide open shot. Good!
Idaho is going down. Trying to stop Atafo. They didn't get back to the unit.
Hayes drives down the lane. Collision. They call an offensive foul on Hayes.
Oh, Leonard Perry is going to get a technical foul. He's got to get a technical foul, doesn't he? Holy cow. Inbounds to Atafo, the clock runs out, buzzer sounds, and that's going to do it. The Gauchos.
After a successful homestand, the Gauchos embarked on their most important road swing of the season. UCSB managed to pull out two gutty victories at Pacific and at Northridge. In Stockton, the Gauchos were forced to play almost the entire game without star Brendan Fulop, who was injured on the game's first play. The final game of the road swing came at Cal Poly. Unfortunately for the Gauchos, Cal Poly came out ready to play, and the crowd was more intense than any crowd before in Mock Gym. The Mustangs fed off their intensity and shot 56% in the field. The game went back and forth between the two teams, each briefly taking control of the tempo and the score.
Running one-hander at the buzzer. He hit it. Works against Atafo, and Atafo gets the steal, and a turnover by Cal Poly. Two on one, Atafo races it up and in. He finds Fulop in the left corner, off a screen for three. He got it! Brandon Fulop gets a smart for the Gauchos. His first three, his seventh point away three over Jones. He got it! He's on fire! Between the circles, chest pass right to Oliver. Inside right block to Davis. Power step to the hole. He puts it in. He knocks over Schilling, and he puts it in for two. No foul call. Kamara with his back to the goal. Hands it over to Jackson. A loose ball. Steal by Nick Jones. One-on-one of his Kamara.
Shane Schilling, who was all but missing in action during the last meeting, came out on fire and scored 20 points. UCSB had a chance to tie the game in the end, but a three-point attempt by Mark Hull rimmed out, and Cal Poly was able to snap a 10-game losing streak to the Gauchos. Nick Jones led the way for UCSB with 18 points.
He stops, he pops, he shoots, and he hits a shot in the lane, and Jones has 13. Tied it! 51-51 tie, 6:17 to play in the game. Right corner, Grace, a long three. It's in there. Jones at the right wing, finds Fulop at the top, a three on the way, it's short, rebound, Fulop puts it up strong in the lane, and it's good! Off the glass, Fulop followed his own shot, and he puts it in! He's got it by Fulop, takes him inside of the lane, all the way to the cup, lays it up, and in! Hey, Mark got it back, back to Fulop in the left corner, it goes to Jones for three, he got it! He ties the game at 63! 20, Schilling, fadeaway shot from 15, he got it! Circle, finds Cole right side, shot clock at 9, full up, back to Hull at the top, a long 3, he rims it in and out, no good, that would have given the Gauchos the lead, rebound, Cal, shot clock at 18, game clock the same, Atafo spinning in the lane, goes to the cup, layup missing, and the call, offensive foul on Atafo! Miss! Rebound by Cecil Brown for the Gauchos. They have some life. 8 seconds. Gauchos down three. Brown at the top needs help. Hole. 4 seconds. A long three. He missed it short. Rebound. Buckley out of bounds. And the buzzer goes off. It's over. Hole had a good look and a couple short. Cal Poly defeats.
After the loss to the Mustangs, the Gauchos were glad to be back home to host the much-anticipated ESPN Bracket Buster game against the University of Detroit, percent from the field. Detroit took a 51-33 lead with 14:29 left in the game before the Gauchos finally woke up. UCSB went on a furious comeback, and behind a three-point barrage, stormed back to within 1 point at 58-57. UCSB hit five threes during just a five-minute span. Unfortunately, the Gauchos would not make a basket the rest of the way, as Detroit pulled away with a 17-2 run to end the game.
At the top, back to Harris, left angle of three, it's good! And it's now a 9-6 Detroit lead. Clock at 16 at the foul line, Hull driving strong to the hole, he puts it in! Light full court pressure for Armada Titans. There's Davis at the left angle. Push pass to the top, it's Mark Cole. Penetrates one-on-one down to the right side. Cecil Brown for three, he got it! At the top, back to Josh, he swings it left to Cecil, another three left side!
To try to change the momentum of this game.
A strip by the walk-on, Fishman Oliver. And Josh Davis in the right place at the right time.
Shot clock at 20, game clock at 14:30. A shot for three missed by Detroit. Willie Green, the rebound, put back good, and one. And Green cleans up the mess. Top to Warren, inside pass to Coble. Ball taken away by a tackle, a steal, all the way down the floor, drives, and he lays it up and misses it short from point-blank range. Rebound Detroit, here they come, 4-on-2. Willie Green in the lane, floating right-hander goes in for Willie Green, and that's a fourth back to the goal. Finds Cecil, left of the circle, three, it's good. And looks and swings the left side, Hull, open three, he got it! And Hull dribble drive right baseline, stop on the double team, finds a Taco, right side for three, it's there! And a punter is on the move, up the floor, Jones, left side of three, finds full left, right side, a three, on the way, it's good! Full left, puts it in! Five to the left junction, open three, he got it! An elbow right to the face, and they didn't call anything, and a turnover by Detroit! Out of bounds, back to the Jones, they get it to Twine at the top, a long three over a Taco, and he puts it in, Twine at six, Green spins it right to Twine, another three over a Taco, rims in and out, rebound to Riggs, puts it up, and he misses the shot, tips out once, twice, as he finds Willie Green in the corner, driving baseline, hanging jumper in the lane, missing, rebound, Coble lays it up and in. Dancing on the dribble, push pass right to Willie Green, off a screen in the lane, 14 footer on the way, and it's in. Willie Green continues to 6-0 when they hold their opponents below 60 points. The Gauchos have 59 as the clock runs down. This game is over, and Detroit wins over Santa Barbara, 75-59.
Made the Chamber of Commerce here in Santa Barbara very proud. Beautiful day outside. Inside, we expect a pretty darn good basketball game. We're at the Thunderdome. Place on a visiting team, the Long Beach State 49ers doing battle with the hometown Santa Barbara Gauchos.
Swings it right to Hodges, a long three. It's
after the ESPN bust, Fox Sports came to town for a 5 p.m. telecast against the lowly 49ers of Long Beach State. Not even the 4,000 sombreros given out to the crowd could help Long Beach this night, as everything went the way of the Gauchos.
He's now 6-2. The timeline down the lane to the rack, lays it up, caught it, and one, how good a time for a 3-point play. Of the game, full of left baseline, stopped on a double team inside to Cook, layup good, and a foul, and he'll go to the line for one. Thing inside the Whitehead on the left block, back out to Cecil Brown, open three, he got it! Cecil Brown puts it in! Whitehead at the left wing.
UCSB went on a 17-3 run in the first half after falling behind 6-0 to take a 17-9 lead.
Full
Long Beach clawed back within 3 points before the Gauchos went on another 23-10 run to lead 40-24 at the half.
Super since we arrived. A nice steal here.
Crispin Oliver with the basket. To Cecil Brown, and the left block gets Whitehead. Back out to Otako. Open three. Good! Only his 10th three of the year, his fifth point of the game.
Six. Numbers, if they take it in or reset.
Oh. Well, they leave Hull. Hull gets it. It hit every side of the basket, but Hull will take it.
With Roberts on him, goes one-on-one against Roberts.
In the second half, the Gauchos lead reached 20 points, but some poor shooting by UCSB allowed the 49ers to climb back within eight. That was the closest Long Beach would get, as the Gauchos pulled away to win by 24 points. UCSB out-rebounded its opponent 37-21 and upped its record in the Big West to 11-4.
Good, and a 10-0 run by Long Beach is down to a 10-point game. Graham, double teamed. Graham finds a wide open Lawhorn. Layup is good. Edson's bounce pass right to Otako. Looks inside, right corner, Full Love. 17-footer. Who got it? Hurricane shot by Full Love, and that ends the drought. Otako inbounds to Whitehead. Layup. Count it! And one! He'll go to line. Whitehead has. Foul by the way on Pearson. Foul shot up by the big guy. Swish. 12 to shoot. Otako up front. Push pass right in the corner. Jones a three. Good! To play. Here's Davis right at the circle. Bounce pass right block to Cook inside to Ward. Layup. Good by BJ.
Competitive teams in the Big West, and they've really done a remarkable job. So you're hoping now that the Big West.
4 seconds. BJ, a long three. It's missed. Rebound, and that's it. Gauchos win it. Great win for the Gauchos. They win.
Communication Studies major from Oxnard, California, number 35, B.J. Please salute a 6'7" senior law society major from Glendale, California, number 30, Mark.
There's the toss, there's the tap, and it's controlled across the half-court stripe.
The final home game of the season was a time to honor the Gauchos' three seniors, Ray Scoltetti, B.J. Ward, and Mark Holt. It was also a chance for a Gaucho to show the largest crowd of the year that UCSB deserved to win its first ever Big West regular season title. The Gauchos came out firing and never trailed once during the night and started off on a 12-2 run to open the game, taking a 17-4 lead early on. Another run of 21-7 took the Gauchos into halftime, leading 38-18. Nick Jones led the way, scoring all of his 16 points in the first half of the play.
Stauskas at the right angle. Inside that three-point stripe, a shot up and in by Jordan Harris, and they're finally on the board. The 15 to shoot. Jones, a long three. It's good! Jones, 2-on-1. Jones to the rack, way up. Good! Turnaround shot, fade away. Let's go! Oh, and a shot by Josh Davis! A hand right in his face, and he... Here come the Anteater. Schrader, right baseline, collides into it. Josh Davis and an offensive foul on Schrader. Down the lane, right alley. He stops and looks, and he'll take a long two. He hit it! From 17 feet, Nick Jones has not... Davis rolls. He's got it left wing. Dribble drive left baseline to the rack. Pump fake shot is up and in! Right side to Full Love. Thought about the shot. Finds Hull at the top for three. Good!
16. That's the Gauchos' biggest lead, matching it. They also led 17-4. Full Love ahead of the pack. Jones will score!
Cross court to right to Jones. Wide open three. He got it! Nick Jones on fire! He has 16! Against a Brown. Now a long shot for three. Bounces out. Rebound. Fought for. It's on the deck. Picked up by the Gauchos, and that's it. Halftime is here, and it's all Gauchos. The Gauchos right down the right side, back outside to Fulop. He drives in, floating right hander goes in.
And they're definitely going to get something going. And
Irvine never got closer than 12 points in the second half as the Gauchos defense shut down UCI's big guns. Jacoby Itako held Irvine's Mike Hood scoreless, and he averages 11.5 points per game. Adam Parada was limited to only 6 points, while the team in general shot 30% from the field and only 23% from behind the arc. UCSB shot 49%. Jones led the way with his 16 points, Brendan Fulop chipped in 15, and Mark Hull, playing in his final home game ever, scored 13. Hull also moved into second place on the all-time UCSB scoring list. The win snapped Irvine's 7-game winning streak and also gave the Gauchos a slim half-game lead in the Big West.
There's a switch up bottom at the foul line of Coro, 15-footer missing, rebound by Cecil Brown's got it for the Gauchos. Cecil up the floor, in transition, he stops, down the lane, folding right-hander, it's in there! Cecil Brand. Cecil gets a screen from Mark at the top. Open three. On the way. He hit it! Three. Steps inside. Into Parada. His shot is good. Off the glass. In the game. Approaching the 4-minute mark left in the game. Gauchos by 12. A steal by Itako. And he breaks out of the pack. 3-on-1. Oh, way up on the way. And he puts it in.
15 points. Jones with 16 leading the way. Now Fulop with a step back three. Duano!
Gauchos looks for a three. It's not there. Zuzak will shoot a three. An air ball from the top. It's out of bounds for the Gauchos. And the fans let him know about it. So DJ Ward across the timeline. 2-on-2. Ward to the glass. Lays it in! Steal by DJ. Up ahead to Fulop. Goes up and he slam dunks it! Slam dunk for Fulop! And that's the Negra! At the top, down the lane, inside Derek Wheeler, way up, good! Derek Wheeler with his first field goal made of the season!
Rest of the game. Really proud of the effort and really happy for the seniors to go out that way at home.
Yep. Thank you, guys.
A chance to win it outright by going and taking care of business next week on the road. And we have to have efforts like this, not only to win the championship, but to prepare ourselves to go in and go to war in the Big West tournament. 1, 2, 3,
Gauchos!
The Gauchos at center court. There's the toss and the tap against Popso, and so there's Itako.
The Gauchos headed into their final road trip of the season in control of their own destiny. UCSB could clinch the number one seed in the Big West tournament with one victory and claim the outright Big West regular season championship with two wins. First up was Cal State Fullerton, which shocked the Gauchos in a stunning overtime win in the Thunderdome earlier in the season. UCSB struggled from the field early on and trailed 8-3 out of the gate. But the Gauchos would wake up and eventually went on a 30-17 run to take a 33-25 lead into halftime. Brendan Fulop scored 13 points
three.
In the first half.
Good! Fulop swings him up the hole, dribbling left baseline. He stopped, finds Fulop, left side of three. He put it in! Keen to shoot, Gauchos by 7. Fulop, left side of three. It's good again! Oh my goodness! He has 5 threes in the night, and the Gauchos lead by 10. Here comes Zachy
at the
Smith
start of the second period, the Gauchos opened up a 10-point lead, but allowed the Titans back into the game as Fullerton went on a 13-3 run to tie the score at 42 apiece with just over 11 minutes remaining. UCSB mounted a 4-point lead late in the game, but Fullerton was able to get within one after a Popso layup made the score 61-60. The Gauchos made 2 free throws at the end, and a 3-point attempt by Ralph Holmes rimmed out at the buzzer to give the Gauchos a 63-60 victory. Fulop led the Gauchos with 19 points, while Nick Jones added 15. The victory gave UCSB its first number one seed for the Big West tournament. And two nights later, the Gauchos easily handled UC Riverside for its 14th conference win, good enough to claim its first ever outright regular season crown.
And no whistle. Ball tipped away and stolen by the Titans. 5 seconds to go. Here's Bolton at the top to Smith. 2 seconds. Left side Holmes a three for the tie. It's short and the game's over. And the Gauchos hold on to win 63-60. They clinch a share of the Big West regular season title.
The Gauchos took their number one seed into the 2003 Big West Conference Tournament and opened up against the Pacific Tigers. Both teams struggled early on, and no one seemed to be able to find the basket. The Tigers led at halftime 21-16. Amazing, since the Gauchos missed 18 of their first 20 shots.
Layup good, and that ends for Trout. And Jones has the second Gaucho field goal of the game. Whitehead's got it at the top. Full Love, wide open three. He got it. There's a start. Full Love with his first three. Out the clock, and the first half is over. And thankfully, it's over, but it wasn't pretty for either team. Pacific, top of the circle. Full Love for three. He hit it. Full Love second.
With 13:42 left in the second half, the Gauchos trailed 31-25. UCSB finally woke up and went on an 11-0 run to take a 36-31 lead. Mark Hull led the charge with 6 of those 11 points. Pacific climbed back into the game and were only down by 1 when UCSB went on another 6-0 run to go up 44-37, and after that, the Tigers just couldn't get any closer. The Gauchos were able to pull out the victory despite shooting a season-low 26% from the field. UCSB was ready for the rematch with the Cal Poly Mustangs and the right to enter the Big West Finals.
Game at 31. Good penetration move there by Chrisman Oliver. Pacific calls timeout. All of a sudden, little bit of surge of energy by the Gauchos on offense. Looking for help. Push pass right. Full of wide open three. He hit it from outside. Full of from downtown. Puts the Gauchos up by 7. Timeout. Gauchos.
You are understating it. That wasn't downtown. That was deep, deep downtown.
Won by Otako. Moniker will make a cockle rather for three, and he put it in.
Oh, that was a deep shot, too.
Gauchos lead a three by Cockle from the top. Rims out, rebound Whitehead. Outlet to Otako. 7 seconds ahead of the floor. Full Love, all alone. Goes up, and he got clobbered from behind by Cockle. That's an intentional foul.
That's a stupid play by Cockle. This game is over, and he can hurt somebody.
Now a scuffle underneath the basket between Karekic and Cecil Brown.
Cecil Brown's coming to his buddies.
It's a Full Love. He'll dribble out the clock. 1 second left. This game is over. Santa Barbara, you can breathe a sigh of relief. The Gauchos, despite shooting 26%, win the game 53-44. They survive in advance and move on to the semifinal round of the Big West Men's Basketball Tournament tomorrow night at 6 o'clock. They'll take on Cal Poly. Final score, Gauchos 53, Pacific 44. Our postgame begins after you hear this from the leader in local.
Up and under move. Nope, dumps it right side. Hull, turnaround shot, right hand. Air ball controlled by Whitehead. Puts it up strong. He missed a tap up. Good by Mark Hull.
The Gauchos and Mustangs were both ready to do battle, and the Gauchos' shooting seemed to be back in full swing. Both teams traded baskets through the first half, and at the break, the Gauchos held a slim one-point lead.
Davis puts it up strong, and he got the roll, and he puts it in. Heavily by Patterson, takes him to the cup, floating right-hander, missing, rebound on the deck, controlled by Jones, puts it up, count it, and one. He'll get a line for a three-point play. To the angle, it goes to Deary, driving left baseline, hanging jumper is good, count it, and a foul on Whitehead. A ball looked like it was going to go. It goes left block to Dennis, puts it up strong, left hand. And got it. Under, looks inside. Cook down low. Back out to Otako. A long three. He hit it. Otako rings the bell. His first field goal. And his fifth point of the game. Down 15 to shoot. Hull, left wing. Looks inside. Gets it down low to Jones. Power step inside. Missed the shot. Whitehead the board. Pump fake up once. Twice and goes in for two. Finds Otako. and throws up a prayer, hits the top of the backboard, and that's it. Halftime is here. The Gauchos are in front. Your halftime score, UCSB 30, Cal Poly 29. Here is Allen of the left angle with a top.
In the second half, UCSB caught fire and took a five-point lead, but Cal Poly came right back to tie the score at 46 with 10:52 to play. The Mustangs then used an 11-2 run to go up 57-48 with 5:43 left in the game. UCSB couldn't cut into the lead and was forced to foul the Mustangs. Unfortunately, Cal Poly made 10 of 11 free throws down the stretch and pulled out the win to make their first ever tournament final in program history. Nick Jones led the Gauchos with 19 points, but Brendan Fuller, the newly crowned Big West Player of the Year, was held to just 2 points on 0-for-8 shooting. The Gauchos' season came to a disappointing end for Sylvan Park.
As he had a broken nose earlier, here's Schilling at the top for three. He hit it. Shane Schilling. Up and under move. Finds Grace at the top for three. He got it. It rolls in there, and Cal Poly takes the lead. It's only Grace's sixth three-pointer made on the whole season. Three to shoot. Geary, a long NBA three. He hit it from 25 feet. How did he put it in? Clock, there's a shot at the buzzer, and it's an air ball with 1.1 on the clock, and a... And the season comes to an end for the Gauchos. They lose in the Big West Tournament semifinal game to Cal Poly. Each other, the coaching staffs as well. And Cal Poly, the 4 seed. All right, well, make this 3 minutes, please.
When the field for the NIT tournament was announced, everyone was surprised that the Gauchos were among the teams invited to play. UCSB would travel to Cox Arena on the campus of San Diego State for an opening round game against the Aztecs. San Diego State had never won a postseason game in its history. The Gauchos came out firing, with Brendan Fuller hitting his first 2 shots and Mark Hull hitting a pair of 3-pointers. UCSB had the lead at halftime and increased that lead in the second half.
Water right all over our stuff. Bounce pass into the paint. Jones' shot is blocked away. Jones got it back and put it in. And the Gauchos are on top by 1-4. Left side pass to Bland. Driving on Full Love. And it's stripped away by Full Love. The outlet pass now to BJ. 2-on-1. Now 3-on-1. Jones for the layup. He lays it in. As Cook, left block, needs help. To Hull, left side, open three. He got it! Three on top, push pass right to Hull. Hull, right block to Jones, layup there. First half of play, shot clock at 15. McHale's pass knocked away. Hull has it in front of us, a turnover. Lead pass to Brown, driving layup, right hand off the glass. Bland, 4 seconds at the top, a long three by Bland. It's strong. Rebound by McHale. His shot at the buzzer is no good. And halftime is here. Up the floor, Burns. Right side fakes the three. Dumps it down low. Sanders, turnaround shot is good. Bland, left side, 15-footer. Yes. Down the lane, dumps a down low to Brian Whitehead, power step to the hole, reverse layup is good! He went underneath the goal and reversed his shot.
The Aztecs were able to claw back into the game. Both teams traded big shots and the lead, but the Gauchos would not fold. Late in the game, a Cecil Brown turnaround jumper gave UCSB a 2-point lead. The Aztecs' next shot would not fall, and the Gauchos had a chance to ice the victory, but a layup by Nick Jones would not fall, and San Diego State had one last shot.
Layup good. seconds to shoot at the foul line, into the lane, dumps it left side, Hall baseline shot, yes, for Mark Hall, he puts it in the right hand, it's strong, rebound fought for, Jones had it, and it's knocked away, San Diego State has it, Bland, one-on-one against Ward, layup good. Jones in the lane, 14-footer, he got it! It rims in there, and Jones gives the Gauchos a one-fourth we go here in San Diego. Sir, left side three, swish! He turns, backdoor pass knocked away, turnover by the Gauchos, and taken right back by Josh Davis. Here comes Josh, right side Jones, baseline shot, yes, for Nick Jones! Inside Cecil, left block, turnaround shot with the right hand, it's good! A fadeaway jumper goes for Cecil Brown. On the point, go to by Cecil Brown. Bland to the cup, layup good, hanging shot in the lane, off the glass, and Bland on the Aztecs. Here we come, 52-52 tie. Layup is good in transition by Cecil Brown. Driving right baseline, spinning in the lane, bank shot is missed, rebound, Cecil Brown's got it, little gap, Brown finds Otako, way up front, 9 seconds, Otako down the lane, dumps it down low, Jones, layup is missed, rebound, it's rebounded by San Diego, 7 seconds and they get a timeout. I just found out the Az burns to inbound, looks and finds Bland. 5 seconds, Bland across half court, running right-handed.
Tony Bland, the Aztecs senior guard, took the inbound pass the length of the floor and hit a running jumper with 1.9 seconds left to tie the score and send it into overtime.
Bland, shot at the buzzer, missed, and we go to overtime. Oh my, that could have been a backbreaker. The referee in the center circle, the toss and the tap controlled by Bland at the hall at the left angle. Works on.
In the extra period, Mark Hull did his best to give the Gauchos a victory, making a three-point play off of a basket and a foul, and then hitting a long-range jumper from beyond the arc to put the Gauchos up by 6 points. UCSB could not hold the lead, however, as San Diego State hit a couple of shots and used rebounds on the offensive end to tie the score.
His 28th point down low. He backs in on Whitehead. Turnaround jump shot with the right hand is good, and he's fouled, and he has a chance for a three-point play. Foul shot up and rimming around and out. Rebound by Sanders, though. Back out to the top, it's McHale at the foul line. Running run-hander, it's good. Looks inside against the 2-3 zone.
A three-pointer by Tommy Johnson with 1:14 left in overtime clinched the win for the Aztecs and ended the season for the Gauchos. Hull led the way with his biggest offensive effort since his career high last year in the first round of the NCAA tournament against Arizona. Mark finished with 28 points and 5 three-pointers. UCSB ended its season with a record of 18-14 and with a lot of optimism for the 2004 season.
There is nothing here.